Welcome to Relaxing Boutique Channel. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a bit challenging. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury, but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies, and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. The Vikings Quest. Chapter 1. The Frozen Departure. In the land of the Norse, where the stark cliffs rose like jagged teeth against the sky, the village of Frosthelm lay ensconced in the arms of winter. It was a place where the snow seldom ceased its endless fall and the sun hung low, a reluctant visitor in the vast northern sky. Here, the sea was as much a part of life as the land, for its brine ran in the blood of those who called this harsh expanse home. Erik Redbeard stood at the helm of his longship, the Frost Serpent. His gaze was as piercing as the ice that sheathed his homeland, and his beard was as red as the fire that crackled in meat halls during the long nights of winter. A formidable Viking warrior, he was as renowned for his feats in battle as he was for his unquenchable thirst for the unknown. Tales of distant worlds veiled in eternal frost and whispers of ethereal beings dwelling within had lit the flame of curiosity in his heart, a flame that now roared like the fiercest inferno. For weeks, Erik and his crew had prepared the Frost Serpent for the journey. They had reinforced her hull to withstand the brutal embrace of the ice, stocked her with provisions to outlast the ceaseless appetite of the cold, and carved runes of protection into her timbers. Now, as the first light of dawn scattered silver across the icy sea, they set sail, the wooden dragonhead at the prow cutting through the ocean's skin like a blade through flesh. The air was crisp, carrying the scent of salt and the promise of snow. The crew, a band of 30 hardy souls, were each a story of battles and bravery, their faces withered by the bite of wind and sea. They rowed in silent unison, the rhythm of their oars a solemn beat that accompanied the chant of the ship's figurehead, its eerie hum a dirge for the warmth they left behind. Erik's second in command, Torvald One Eye, a man who had lost his left eye to a raven's beak and gained the sight of omens in return, stood by his side. His gaze lingered on the receding shore, where the silhouettes of their loved ones grew smaller, swallowed by the burgeoning light of day. As the Frost Serpent ventured further from the familiar, the sky became a canvas of gray, the water beneath them a darker hue of despair. Icebergs loomed on the horizon, like specters of the deep, their surfaces gleaming with the spectral light of the hidden sun. The crew's breaths hung before them in the air, phantoms that danced and twisted before dissipating into the void. Days turned to nights, and the night stretched on, a procession of twilight hours indistinguishable from each other, as the ship made her way through waters no Viking had dared to navigate. Erik stood vigilant, his eyes scouring the shifting seascape, his mind wrestling with the silent call that had beckoned him to this desolate expanse. Then, a sight both wondrous and terrifying brought the Frost Serpent to a halt. The sea before them had transformed into a vast field of ice, stretching into the horizon where the sky kissed the frozen earth in a cold embrace. The ocean had surrendered to the might of the frost, and their journey by sea had reached its end. The men muttered amongst themselves, casting wary glances at their captain. Torvald approached Erik, his one good eye reflecting the myriad questions that hung in the air, as palpable as the ice that barred their path. "Redbeard," he said, his voice a gravelly timbre that matched the restless shifting of the ship. "The sea denies us passage. Shall we admit defeat and turn back to warmer tides?" Erik's reply was a chuckle that rumbled from his chest like distant thunder. "Turn back? No, my friend. The Frost Serpent has carried us as far as she can by water. Now, we tread upon the ice. This is but a new path to glory, one that we shall carve with our feet and will." Without waiting for a response, Erik grabbed his axe and shield, his figure imposing against the gray expanse. One by one, his men followed, each donning their furs and grasping their weapons, a testament to their trust in their leader and their own thirst for adventure. Together, they disembarked, stepping onto the ice that crackled under their weight, a symphony of snaps and groans that played with the whispers of the wind. The crew formed a line, with Erik at the lead, and began their march into the frozen labyrinth. The cold was a living thing, clutching at their limbs, gnawing at their resolve. Yet, they pressed on, driven by the promise of discovery and the undying allure of the unknown. It was there, in the heart of the icy expanse, that they first heard it, a whispering that seemed to emanate from the very ice beneath their feet. It was neither language nor song, but something ancient and elemental, a call that resonated with Erik's soul. He halted, his eyes scanning the endless white for its source, and that's when they appeared, the Ice Walkers. Chapter 2. Whispers of the Ice Walkers. As the relentless cold gnawed at the edge of his consciousness, Erik Redbeard led his men across the vast, frozen tableau. The once rhythmic cadence of oars striking water was replaced by the crunch of boots on ice, a staccato against the deafening silence of the frostbound wilderness. Torvald One Eye, ever the seer, had adopted a pensive quiet, his one-eyed gaze scanning the bleak horizon as if to decipher a hidden message in its barren folds. Their destination was as enigmatic as the path that lay before them, known only to the whispers that had haunted Erik's dreams since childhood, tales of a world beyond the world, a place where the spirits of ice reign supreme. As the days passed, the crew spoke little, conserving their breath against the biting cold and the effort of hauling the sleds laden with their meager supplies and the essential remnants of the Frost Serpent. On the fourth night, under a tapestry of stars, the whispers grew louder, no longer confined to Erik's slumbering mind. The crew huddled around a meager fire, its flames a small rebellion against the kingdom of ice, and listened. "They speak in the voice of the glacier, the call of the winter tide," muttered Bjorn, a burly warrior with eyes the color of the sea during a storm. Erik, seated on a throne of packed snow, nodded. "Aye, they speak of the hidden realm, an ancient place veiled in frost, where mortal foot has scarce trod." A silence settled over the men, each lost in their own reverie. The cold had become a relentless adversary, a foe that neither sword nor axe could cleave. Yet, Amidst the creeping frost and the ever-present chill, there was an allure, a siren call that promised wonders and horrors in equal measure. It was as dawn broke the following morn, a pale, half-hearted light that barely touched the edges of night, that they first saw them, the ice walkers. Ethereal figures, tall and lithe, their forms shimmered with the pale luminescence of snow under moonlight. Their eyes were deep wells, aglow with the aurora that danced across the sky in waves of green and violet. The crew reached for their weapons, the metallic sound of drawn swords a sharp note of challenge against the serene quietude of the walkers. Yet, Erik raised his hand, bidding them to stillness. "We have not been sought for battle," he said, his voice a commanding rumble. "They come bearing the wisdom of the ancients." The ice walkers approached, their feet leaving no prints upon the snow. They circled the Vikings, a silent procession of curiosity and grace. The air around them seemed to shimmer, as if they wove the very essence of winter around their forms. One, taller than the rest, stepped forward. Its voice was the sound of wind through ice-sculpted caverns, a melodic timbre that resonated with the very marrow of the world. "Warriors of the South, your journey has pierced the veil of the forgotten realm. What seeks thee in the embrace of the eternal frost?" Erik stood, facing the entity. "We seek the truth behind the tales, the knowledge that lies buried beneath layers of ice and time." The ice walker regarded him, its gaze an ancient and fathomless pool. "Truth is a blade with many edges, Viking. It can defend, or it can wound. Are you prepared to bleed for what you seek?" Erik met its gaze, unflinching. "I am." A murmur rustled through the crew, a blend of awe and fear. They watched as the ice walkers closed their ranks around Erik, their luminous forms casting otherworldly shadows on the snow. The air grew colder, if such a thing were possible, and the fire flickered, threatened by the encroaching frost. Then, the whispers rose to a chant, a cadence that bore the way of aeons, and the world shifted. The snow beneath their feet trembled, and the sky seemed to open, revealing a vision of a realm where the ice grew into structures of wondrous complexity, spires and arches that defied the logic of men. In this vision, a citadel of ice stood, gleaming like a gem within the heart of winter. The chant ceased, and the ice walkers receded, their forms dissipating like mist under the caress of morning light. The vision faded, leaving behind an aching emptiness and the irrefutable knowledge that what they had witnessed was both a map and a warning. Erik turned to his men, his eyes alight with a fervor that was mirrored in their gazes. "The path is revealed," he said, his voice carrying the certainty of destiny. "The citadel waits, and with it, the secrets of the ancients." The crew rallied, a newfound vigor infusing their limbs. The sleds were packed with haste, and they set off, following the ethereal trails left by the ice walkers, deeper into the heart of the unknown. The whispers continued to guide them, a haunting lullaby that spoke of ages past and glories forgotten. With each step, the boundary between myth and reality blurred, until they could no longer discern where one ended and the other began. They were no longer merely men, they were pilgrims on a sacred journey, traversing a bridge between worlds, a bridge wrought of ice and whispering shadows, leading to the very heart of the eternal winter. Chapter 3. Beneath the Aurora's Gaze. The journey pressed on to the celestial dance of the aurora borealis, its shifting hues painting the heavens with the colors of spirits long gone. The men had grown silent, each lost in contemplation of the sights beheld under the twilight of the eternal ice. The path, as revealed by the ice walkers, wound deeper into the heart of the frozen wastes, where no man had tread. Erik Redbeard, ever the stoic leader, felt a tremor of unease in his gut, an instinct honed by years of navigating treacherous seas and battles. This was no enemy one could strike with steel, no glory to be won with bravery alone. Here, in this desolate expanse, the very elements conspired against them. The cold had seeped into their bones, a relentless specter that whispered of surrender, yet the Viking spirit within them burned fiercely, a flame that refused to be quenched by the frost's cruel embrace. Their provisions waned, each meal smaller than the last, but hunger was a familiar adversary, one they met with grim determination. As they camped beneath the pulsing lights of the aurora on the seventh night, the air itself seemed charged with a strange energy. The colors above swirled with greater fervor, casting eerie shadows upon the ice that crunched underfoot. The men huddled closer to the fire, watching the display with a mixture of awe and apprehension. Torvald One Eye, the seer, rose from his seat. His single eye, milky white and often perceived as a window to other realms, reflected the aurora's glow. "The veil thins," he said, his voice carrying the weight of prophecy. "We stand on the precipice of the ancient world. The ancestors speak through the lights, and their message is clear. We must prepare for the trials ahead." The crew watched, breaths held, as Torvald walked to the edge of the camp, raising his arms to the sky. He chanted in the old tongue, a language of runes and myths, and the aurora seemed to respond, its color swirling into a vortex of otherworldly beauty. That night, as the Vikings lay in their furs, a dream came upon them all, shared yet unique. They dreamt of the citadel of ice, its spires reaching for the stars, its walls the color of the northern lights. In their dreams, the citadel was alive, its heartbeat a slow thrum in tune with the rhythm of the cosmos. Morning came, bearing no respite from the cold. The crew broke camp with urgency, the dream's vivid imagery fueling their resolve. Their path now followed a frozen riverbed, its surface a mosaic of ice and stone, leading them ever onward. As the days passed, signs of life began to emerge in the most unexpected forms, trees encased in ice, their branches stretching out like hands frozen in supplication, and creatures of the ice, their fur thick and white, watching the intruders with curious eyes that glowed in the twilight. On the 12th day, as the sun dipped below the horizon, granting only a few hours of dim light, they arrived at the edge of a vast chasm. Its depths yawned beneath them, a darkness so profound it seemed to consume the very light. Bjorn approached Erik, his usually stoic face etched with concern. "What manner of sorcery is this, my chief? The earth has split to devour us." Erik studied the chasm, his gaze steely. "This is no sorcery, Bjorn. It is a trial, as foretold by the ice walkers. We must find a way across." The crew set to work, crafting a bridge with the wood from their sleds, ropes made from twisted furs, and the indomitable will of men who refused to falter before nature's challenge. Each step across the precarious bridge tested their courage, the abyss below a constant threat, ready to claim any who might slip. With each member's safe passage, a collective sigh of relief rose into the cold air, their breaths forming clouds that mingled with the whispers of the chasm. They stood on the other side, a testament to their tenacity, staring back at the abyss as if to defy it once more. As night fell, and the aurora once again painted the sky with its otherworldly brush, the men felt an energy pulsing from the ice beneath their feet. It was as if the very ground acknowledged their achievement, welcoming them into the fold of this ancient and mysterious world. The following days brought them into a valley where the ice formed pillars and arches, a silent forest of frost. Here, the signs of the ice walkers became more frequent, their ethereal trails leading the men through the labyrinth of ice towards a destiny that seemed written in the stars. Chapter 4. The Citadel of Whispers. In the pale light of the Arctic dawn, the crew of Norsemen gathered, their breaths like wraiths in the frigid air. Erik Redbeard, standing tall against the icy winds, scanned the horizon. The path had led them to the base of a towering glacier, its surface reflecting the ethereal light of the dawn. The whispers of the ice walkers were stronger here, a symphony of ancient voices carried on the wind. The citadel lies within, Torvald One Eye intoned, his voice barely above a whisper, yet it carried the certainty of the stars. The crew, hardened by their journey, felt a shiver that had little to do with the cold. The citadel of their dreams, the culmination of their quest, was near. They approached the glacier with reverence. The ice, blue and deep as the ocean, was carved with symbols that none could comprehend, yet all felt their significance. It was a language older than memory, predating the sagas of their people. With axes and ropes, they began to ascend the face of the glacier. The climb was treacherous, each foothold a battle against the slipping, betraying ice. The wind howled like the Valkyries in flight, threatening to cast them into the abyss below. But the Vikings were relentless, driven by a force that surpassed the fear of death. Halfway up the colossal wall of ice, Erik halted, his gaze fixed on a peculiar formation, a gateway of sorts, framed by two towering pillars of ice, each etched with runic carvings that glowed faintly in the morning light. The gateway hummed with an unseen energy, beckoning them forward. The crew gathered at the threshold, the air around them alive with the power of the ancient runes. Erik reached out, his fingers brushing against the ice. The moment his skin made contact, a shudder ran through the glacier, and the gateway began to open, revealing a dimly lit passage beyond. Inside, the air was still, the silence profound. They walked through corridors of ice, their footsteps echoing in the hallowed chambers. The walls were lined with intricate frescoes, depicting scenes of a time when gods walked among men and the world was young. The Vikings gazed upon them with a sense of awe, their hearts heavy with the gravity of their discovery. The passage led them to a vast hall, where the ice formed an intricate dome above. In its center stood an altar, upon which lay a single object, a horn, carved from some unknown material, adorned with runes that pulsed with the same light as those on the gateway. Torvald approached the altar, his long eye reflecting the luminescent runes. He spoke, his voice resonating through the hall, "This is the Horn of Winter." It is said that its call can awaken the earth and command the elements. A gift from the gods, waiting for those worthy to claim it. Erik stepped forward, his hand hovering above the horn, feeling the raw power that emanated from it. "We came seeking the citadel and its secrets," he said, turning to his crew, "but this is more than mere stone and ice. This is a legacy of the ancients, a testament to their mastery of forces we can scarce comprehend." The crew knelt, a silent pact among them. They were no longer just warriors and explorers, they were guardians of a legacy that spanned eons. The responsibility of the Horn of Winter was theirs, a charge that would forever alter the course of their lives. They stayed in the hall for a time, each man wrestling with the enormity of their discovery. As the light from the entrance began to fade, signaling the approach of dusk, they prepared to depart, the Horn of Winter wrapped carefully in furs. Their descent from the glacier was a solemn affair, each man lost in thought. The whispers of the ice walkers were now a gentle hum, an approval of the path the Vikings had chosen. They had come seeking glory and found wisdom, they had come as seekers and left as sages. Upon returning to their homeland, the story of their journey would be woven into the sagas, a tale to inspire generations. The Horn of Winter would be guarded, its power respected and its voice silent, until the day it was needed to awaken the earth and herald the dawn of a new age. As the Viking longship sailed away from the shores of the frozen world, the aurora borealis flared brightly above, a bridge between earth and the heavens. And the whispers of the ice walkers followed them, a soft, ethereal lullaby that spoke of the unbreakable bond between the men and the ancient citadel they had uncovered beneath the gaze of the northern lights.